Hey, everyone. Yeah, it's a big pleasure for me to be here today. We are building a limitless, meaning no level cap, no skill cap, 3D play-to-earn blockchain MMORPG. We've been working on this for, actually, I'll just go back, not spoil anything just yet. So we started working on a game design 2 years ago for this. I'm a big gamer myself, and I have a lot of friends as well who are. I'm a YouTuber as well. I have about 4 million subscribers on YouTube. I've been into the YouTube, Patreon scene, etc. for a long time, way like 10 years or 15, whatever it is now. One thing that always annoyed me, if you just for a second forget about anything blockchain or earning or anything, from a game perspective, you play a game like World of Warcraft, right? And you put in thousands of hours in it, in a season. And the result, after you level up and you spend all your time in raids, etc., is that as soon as there's a new expansion, then everyone's the same again, right? Because everyone gets the same items. Ooh. Anyway, so that annoyed me, and I want to have a game that has no level cap and no skill caps. Like, if you watch a cinematic, you will actually be able to be that powerful. So with that in mind, I started a company about 2 years ago. We got it together in July last year, where we have, we're starting to make this game. So we have David, who's a well-known game designer from RuneScape, which is the world's largest free MMORPG. And we have Brett Dunham as well from Activision, or Blizzard. And then me personally, I'm taking care of the game design, of course, and also the music, and I've made music and worked with, I'll make music for some of these companies that are on the list, and others as well, but including League of Legends and Magic the Gathering, Power Rangers, etc. It's a very big passion project. Some of the most important things about DOMI is that it's an everlasting one. I already mentioned it, but the biggest deal is that it has no level cap and no skill cap, so it potentially is fun forever, and no one can take that away from you. Because that always pisses me off when they do that, where you're like, yeah, you spend some, like, I'm sure you know, right? Like, I play World of Warcraft, and I play for like 18 hours every day, and my feet swell up, I gotta go to the ER, and then they're introducing a new expansion, and then you just have nothing. I hate that. So that's why it's everlasting. Of course, we're building it on Avalanche's subnet technology, which we're on the stage right now. I would like to just go through all of this, but I know there's been some speeches today, and people talk a lot about their visions and stuff, but we've been building this game for ages, so we actually have a game, and it's very good. So if I can ask those boys in the corner to play the first video, please, then everyone can see the game we have. That would be great. Just blast the sound, by the way.
Welcome to DOMI Online. Sweet dreams. See you in DOMI.
Oh. Right, so now you got to see that we actually have a game. And so none of that is cinematic. All of that is in-game footage, just recorded with OBS software or Unity Recorder tool. So I can carry on then. So yeah, we're building on Avalanche's subnet. I'm going to get back to that in this presentation. Part of what we're doing as well is in a lot of NFT projects, a lot of stuff because of the whole earning model and stuff, a lot of stuff is paid to win because you want to make it play to earn. Big conversation we've had during our race and during everything we've done is a lot of companies want to make it as much pay to win as possible because it increases the chances for play to earn. So we're not doing that. So all our items and everything we have, including houses, is underpinned by NFTs. And they're giving small perks, like if you sleep in a house, you can regenerate mana overnight. And keep in mind, like I just said, and just show you, this is all live on our, we all have this in the game already. But the items and everything are made so that you cannot get too powerful. You got to be able to spend your time actually grinding out experience, etc. So you're going to want to make an everlasting experience. So we have leaderboards and seasonal rewards, NFT-supported player house and loot system, and then, of course, we have guilds. We have the assets supported by Avalanche tokens, of course, NFTs. I'm sure everyone here is very familiar with it. So depending on the different tier NFT you have, the different size you have, you're going to go into its client side, and then you can the main perk for players from to benefit from the actual houses is regenerating mana when you're offline. But it's also like a cool thing to have, similar to all these PFP projects holding something, just like a piece of art. I think we actually have one more video for that. It's a pretty short one. Feel free to play this video, boys. Thank you. So, yeah, it's a pretty bad video. I did my best, but I had like 1 hour before going to Barcelona, so should have added sound effects and stuff. I'm really proud of the game, but just so that hurt my feelings, to be honest. I couldn't edit it better, but it's a real game, so it's fun. So that just showcases kind of like how we want to use the NFTs in our system. I didn't say this already, but I can mention it. I actually released the world's first ever NFT music album. Snoop Dogg says he's going to do it now, but I did it. You can check the blockchain. It doesn't lie. So that's a long time ago. And we also did Logan Paul's NFTs, Tekashi 6ix9ine's, Tory Lanez, etc. We were working with NFTs for way before all of this stuff. So I know all the benefits of it. I also know all the issues and all the challenges with it and all the people hating on it. But the technology is amazing, and we just can't see making this game in the future without utilizing everything, including what the guy who was just here talked about with interoperability, which is great, but also actual ownership. So one of the things that annoy me, and like I said from the start, like even just talking about it even if you don't include the blockchain side, right? Just to be able to get actually strong is something we've been missing in games for a while. Old games do it. I don't know why I keep looking at it, but I'm sorry. I feel like we have this connection, so I'm sorry. I can move on. I just keep speaking. So here's our roadmap. We've gotten really far, and I'm super proud of our team and everyone we have here. It's not, like I said at the start, it's not just any kind of team. It takes a lot of effort to get a team with experience from proper games, and especially making an MMORPG, it's a big challenge. So I'm sure someone's streaming this live somewhere. So David and Brett and Pavel, everyone on the team, I love you guys. You're amazing. And I'm a musician, and I just a guy who had an idea, but even me, I wake up in the morning, spend the entire day in Unity, working with database work and with environments and everything. So yeah, it's a process. So that's just some of the people on the team. Some of them are here today, which is pretty cool. I'm not sure I need to actually talk about this in the presentation. I think I already talked about it. So the DOMI token, I'm going to get to this next page, which is basically what's interesting for you guys here, because it's kind of unique. But I'll just go quickly over it, because we did leave it in the presentation. So the DOMI token used for governance, which is a big deal in the MMORPG scene, because, well, it, not that it's used a lot, but it can be a big deal for us, because you can basically balance out everything from spells and characters and areas and everything, and that's a big deal in gaming. So we want to use governance for that. And then, of course, staking. We've had staking live on Trader Joe. I don't know if there's any Trader Joe people here right now, but big fan. So we've had staking live there for a while now. And then, so of course, the entire ecosystem is underpinned by NFTs, and so our DOMI token is used to purchase and sell assets on the market. So I want to get to, and sorry to do this, by the way. I know it's really lame, but I was told by both our lawyers and our COO that I had to read from a script for this next bit, because we have partners who just say, like, you know. So so I will do that. I said I wanted to wing it, but they insisted. So I can wait with the script for a little bit. So the subnets are a big deal for us, because when we're underpinning the ecosystem with NFTs, if an item drops, and let's say we were working on Ethereum. I'm sure everyone has an NFT on Ethereum, right? And Ethereum is great, but it's expensive, and everyone hates the Ethereum gas fees. And if we're building a game on any blockchain, as soon as something drops, if it's a sword or an armor or anything, you can't really have the player, especially if we're looking for mass adoption, etc. Which I believe that mass adoption can be through GameFi. So when an item drops, it needs to. You make an account, you play it, and then the item basically needs to be free to loot, right? And that's something that these subnets are doing for us. We can have virtually free transactions. So we're working along Avalanche, utilizing their unique and innovative subnet technologies to create this experience, and basically also enabling a new level of blockchain performance that we haven't seen before. It's an own dedicated kingdom which can be customized to the needs and uses of not only our players, but a welcoming environment for future partners of DOMI to unite under one subnet. And so for me personally, the whole subnet speech is about the transaction, which is insane, really. If you're building something and you want people to loot stuff and it's NFTs, there's always a transaction. So paying for that is insane. But that's what Avalanche helps us sort out. So we were very bullish on Avalanche a long time ago because of this fact. And then we have the second one there, which is DeFi or DeFi, depending on how you pronounce it, DeFi injection. So I'm sure you know. Just try to read off the script. So basically, I'm sure you know a lot of play to earn is evolved around mining tokens, right? Which we think in a system, in a world like DOMI that is everlasting, a problem with that is that your people are mining your, like in a game where you're mining tokens, then you're draining liquidity. I'm sure you can all agree. Like, I think we've seen it as well. So we have a solution for that, for making P2E valuable and sustainable over time, just like the whole model of the game. And that's something we call DeFi injection, which I think is going to be something new that we haven't seen before in the space, which is basically we set a large portion of funding into various dApps like Trader Joe, Arve, Balancer, and Curve, and then allowing the yield generated throughout the season will be locked and cast to our community to vote on how they want to distribute it. So it's a play-to-earn system that doesn't hurt the token price or the liquidity, which I think is an amazing idea. So if anyone else are working on a game in this room right now, then think about it. For me, it's a no-brainer. I'm excited, and I think that that's a much better and more sustainable way of doing P2E. So finally, and this is the one where I really needed to look at my phone, because we are working with our partner's charged particles protocol. So once deployed on Avalanche, we aim to leverage their protocol to provide our players with the unique ability to not only benefit from in-game functionality, but also the ability to allow us to lock interest-bearing yield tokens from dApps such as our way within our NFT permanently, allowing our holders on purchase to earn and claim additional passive income just by holding our NFTs, always playing our fully immersive MMORPG. Charged Particles is a protocol that is sparking a DeFi revolution in GameFi. DOMI Online is proud to work alongside our latest partners to begin Avalanche development to make sustainable GameFi a reality. So, like I said, I had to say that because our lawyers and everything. But you understand what it is, right? So yeah, you basically bake yield-bearing tokens inside of it. So like, if I explain it to someone, I would explain it's like, yeah, you have money in the bank and you make interest. You can bake that into the NFTs. And I think everyone knows like the APR and APR on tokens are pretty good on apps like Nexo. And so yeah, we can basically, I showed you a video before with the skins and with the houses. And that's basically it. You can hold those skins, which will, if you look at skins in games like Counter-Strike, for instance, whereas I've spent tons of money myself for Dragon Lords and Howls and all that stuff, you can hold those, but you also earn passive income from holding it because of charged particles. I showed you two videos. I hope I did a good presentation, guys. I love this project. Like I said, we have an actual game, and we have developers who are amazing from Blizzard, from RuneScape, myself included, and I recommend you have a look at it. You can go to domionline.io. I have no idea how much time I spent, but that's basically what I got. So thank you.
Awesome. Thank you, PelleK.